welcome to ABC Interactive English. That is Karen.
And that is Henry.
Mm-hmm. And today we are looking at day two of A Window on the World. And it's still called La Tomatina, the world's biggest food fight. And the vocabulary words are...
Kilogram. Kilogram. Jesse lost 15 kilograms last fall.
Sheet. Sheet.Debbie put a sheet on the table before the kids started painting.
Ham. Ham. Every Easter, Grandma cooks a big ham for us.
Strike. Strike. School ends when the clock strikes three.
That's right.
Karen, guess what was one of the first English words that I've learned?
Is it one of our vocabulary words today?
Yes.
Strike?
No. Yes, strike. No,
I don't know, maybe from baseball.
No, it was ham, and it was because of my ama, my grandma.
Really? Is it because your grandma likes ham?
Well, we had ham for breakfast or, you know, meals on occasions, and because she was educated by the Japanese, and Japanese said 火腿 was hamu.
Oh, okay.
Right.
So they use the English word,
right.
Hamu.
Yes.
It's ham.
Yeah. Hiragana, katakana.
That's right.
Right. Japanese, the language has a
katakana.
Lot of... Yeah, katakana.
They use English, other language.
They transfer the sounds.
That's right.
Like basketball.
And I think it's computa. It's computer.
Okay. Interesting.
So you can understand a lot, you know, if you talk to like a Japanese person, you can understand maybe, you know, you can guess the English words. Okay, and the question for today is, how do store owners prepare for the La Tomatina food fight?
How do store owners prepare for the La Tomatina food fight?
La Tomatina.
La Tomatina.The world's biggest food fight.
Now, people throw the tomatoes for fun. It's a big event. Buñol buys over 100,000 kilograms of tomatoes. Store owners cover their windows with plastic sheets to protect them. When it's time, 20,000 people go into the village square. In the middle of the square, a ham sits on a tall, greasy pole. Once someone gets the ham,The food fight begins. When the clock strikes 12, people stop throwing tomatoes. By that time, the square is covered in tomato sauce. So are all of the happy people there.
Explanation 1.
Hi, I'm Jeff.
Hi, I'm Hanny.
Welcome to day 2 of this month's A Window on the World. On day 1 of our lesson,We began reading about a festival called La Tomatina. The main attraction of this festival is a food fight. The biggest food fight in the world.
Yep, people participating in this food fight throw tomatoes at one another. Anyway, in case any of you have forgotten, the title of this month's lesson is La Tomatina, the world's biggest food fight.Okay, let's get started.
The first La Tomatina food fight was unplanned. Some angry guy started throwing stuff, tomatoes included, after he fell down during a parade. The next year, people brought tomatoes with them and again threw them out of anger.
That's true, but that was then. Now people throw the tomatoes...For fun, and it's a big event. Get this, La Tomatina's host city, Buñol, Spain, buys over 100,000 kilograms of tomatoes for the festival.
Wow, 100,000 kilograms of tomatoes? I'll say it again. Wow. That's a lot. Also, the word kilogram is the first vocabulary wordof the day. Kilogram. Kilogram. It's a noun. A kilogram is a unit of measure for weight. 1 kilogram equals 1,000 grams. Kilograms, everyone, very simply, are used to measure or to weigh heavy things. For instance, I weigh about 80 kilograms. For example, 1 kilogram is equal to 2.2 pounds.
一公斤差不多是2.2磅。那么 kilogram 这个名词，它就是指公斤。我们平常用 kg 来表示的时候，就是它的缩写。例如 ，Their 10-year-old son weighs about 50 kilograms. Their 10-year-old son weighs about 50 kilograms. 他们那个十岁的儿子体重大约是50公斤，有点过重了。好，来看再看个例句 ，The beef costs $600 per kilogram.The beef costs $600 per kilogram. 这个牛肉的价格是每公斤600元。好，那我们在第一天的课文读到番茄大战的起源。那现在呢，人们丢番茄是为了好玩。在这场盛大活动里面，这个布尼奥尔村呢，会买进超过10万公斤的番茄。天哪，也太多了吧。Well, I can't get over it, Jeff.People throw 100,000 kilograms worth of tomatoes at each other during this food fight. These people must make a total mess of Buñol.
Yes, it is very, very easy to make a mess when throwing tomatoes. But people, especially store owners in Buñol, are ready.
They are ready.Huh? What do you mean?
I mean that they're prepared for anything.
Could you be more specific, Jeff? Could you please tell us how these store owners prepare for the food fight?
No, I won't. You see, if I did, I'd be giving away the answer to the question of the day.
Oh.
How do store owners prepare for the La Tomatina food fight?
Store owners cover their windows with plastic sheets to protect them. Store owners cover their windows with plastic sheets to protect them. And here we have the second vocabulary word of the day, sheet.
Sheet. It's a noun. Let's talk about sheets, everyone. People use sheets made out of cloth or fabric as covering for their beds.Store owners cover their windows with plastic sheets during La Tomatina. I could go on and on and on. Yes, these are all examples of sheets. Further, students like yourselves often write on sheets of paper, rectangle-shaped pieces of paper. Anyways, to be clear, a sheet, in this case, is a flat, usually rectangular piece of material.Sheets are often used when covering or protecting things. For example, if the sheet of plastic on the roof gets a hole in it, it won't be able to keep the rainwater out.
如果屋顶上用来遮盖的布或是板子有洞的话，下雨天就没有办法防止漏水了。Sheet.这个单字当名词可以用来指床单或者是薄薄的布料。例如 ，They covered the furniture with sheets before they started painting. They covered the furniture with sheets before they started painting. 他们要上油漆之前，先用薄薄的布料把家具盖起来，以免沾到油漆。好，另外 ，sheet 也可以用来指一张纸或者是一片薄薄的物品。那通常是方形的，像 a sheet of iron 是一片薄薄的铁片 ，a sheet of glass 表示一片玻璃等等。例如 ，She wrote down her phone number and address on a sheet of paper. She wrote down her phone number and address on a sheet of paper. 她在一张纸上写下她的电话号码还有地址。好，回到课文里面。要炸10万公斤的番茄，这个场面一定非常非常混乱。那么店家们会用塑料布把窗户盖住，免得他们会受到波及。好，那我们先休息一下，待会再回到课文当中。Okay, everyone, time is now becoming an issue.
Correct. And that means it is time for a break. But don't go away, you guys. We'll be back soon.
欢迎收看，
就爱讲英文。
我是悠悠，
我是纪安。
啊、哦，我跟你讲，俗话说得好，中国人说呢，女生一白遮三丑。
真的。
但是我真的觉得，这个亚洲女生很在乎美白呀。
嗯，
就来教大家怎么样美白呀。
美白哈，第一步就是要干嘛？防晒。
防晒。
防晒比那个擦那个任何那些美白产品都还来重要。
真的。
防晒。Okay,
防晒。
擦就是 apply。
apply。
好 ，apply sunscreen。
Apply sunscreen，
或者 apply sunblock。
Apply sunblock，
就是擦防晒乳啦。OK， 那再的话，有些人会用那个美白的面膜，
哦、
对不对？
一定要。
面膜、哦、就是 facial mask。
Facial mask。
Facial mask。
我跟你讲，面膜的种类跟学问可大的呢。
那就用比较猛的哈。Intensive， 你看 intensive 这个字就厉害了，
厉害了。
深度的、强度很够的 intensive whitening mask。
Intensive whitening mask。
深度的美白面膜。
嗯。还有很多的抗老的、啊、抗皱的、啊、你知道女生很在意哦，各种这个面膜它的功效是不一样，
什么都要抗，
抗老、抗皱、
哎、抗地心引力，
当然了，是不是
抗呢？我们用一个字首就是 anti
anti、
哦、
uncle uncle、哦、不是 sorry
anti OK、
嗯、
就是抗，所以呢你说要抗皱的话呢，就是 anti wrinkle
anti wrinkle
抗老吗？
抗老
anti aging
Anti-aging，
有些人会念 anti-aging，OK、okay? 嗯。然后还有什么？要
哦，紧致皮肤
紧致
哦，有没有？
紧肤
很怕抬头纹、
哦。我们用 firm 这个字 ，F-I-R-M， 它当形容词的话呢，就是很紧实的。那当动词呢，就是让它紧实啊、哦。所以 firming 它可以紧实你的肌肤。
这么紧，
对，
好不好
？OK
哦。哦，不管是白天哈、哦，晚上哦，都要敷面膜，好不好？让我们看起来像冰冰的、嗯、冰冰，好不好？
容光焕发，
是的。
那让自己看起来是容光焕发的样子、嗯，你可以有一个片语啊，叫做 perk up， perk up，
perk up，
perk up， 就让你自己容光焕发的那种感觉啊。
Yes.
所以呢 ，I use facial masks to perk up my skin， 让我的皮肤
bling
bling bling and pamper myself。
Oh, I use facial masks to perk up my skin and
pamper myself. Okay,
myself.
Pamper 这个字呢，在一个地方你可以看得到。
等一下，这种尿片的名字吧？
对啊，
帮宝适。
帮宝适就是 pamper， 但 pamper 它原来的意思呢是什么？呵护的意思。Pamper myself， 帮宝适我自己啊，没有，就是呵护我自己，好不好？
那个皮肤跟小朋友的屁屁一样嫩的意思，好会取名字哦 ，pamper，OK。
Pamper,
okay? 但是美白就是要皮肤不暗沉，暗沉怎么说？
暗沉就是 dull and dark skin。
Dull and dark skin。
Dull 的话就是完全没有光彩的哦，就是、
暗沉。
Dark 就是黑这样。好，那相反的话就是怎么样？像这样容光焕发 ，glowing。Glowing skin 就是皮肤非常的亮白，这样
是的，
对。
但是也很多人会注意这个眼部还有唇的保养，
对，这些都非常的重要。
是是
OK， 所以你如果听到有一个哦，他真的很会保养，你就可以跟他说 ，Sounds like you take really good care of your skin.
You can say that again.
Sounds like you take really good care of your skin.
That's right.
对，就这样。
Yes. 是不是大家一定要好好保养了，好吗？
来看一下今天的 live action。
Oh, today was so hot.
It is.
I'm going to put on an intensive whitening mask tonight.
Whitening mask?
Yes.
What's it for?
I use facial masks to perk up my skin and pamper myself. I want a glowing skin.
I see.
Yeah. And I'm going to apply some anti-aging products too.
Sounds like you take really good care of your skin.
Of course.
Explanation 2.
Welcome back. Before the break, we learned that Buñol buys over 100,000 kilograms of tomatoes for the La Tomatina food fight. And yes, folks, people throw these 100,000 kilograms worth of tomatoes at each other during this food fight.
Yup. Now, more on the fight itself. When it's time to fight, 20,000 people go into the village square. Then things get a little weird. You see, the food fight doesn't begin right away.
Right.There's a ritual that the food fighters follow. In the middle of the square, a ham sits on a tall, greasy pole. And strange as it sounds, people try to get this ham that is on the greasy pole. And once someone gets the ham, the food fight begins.
I know it sounds weird, but that's how the La Tomatina food fight works. And who are we to judge? Anyway, here we have the third vocabulary word of the day, ham. 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 It's a noun. Ham is a delicious, salty meat. Yum. Ham, specifically, is meat that comes from a pig. It usually comes from the leg of a pig, or when we use this word ham, we're referring to the meat of a pig's leg that has been cooked together like a big roast and then sliced up. Oh yeah, ham is delicious. Anyways, ham is pork, though I believe the word ham is being used in a specific way in our article. For example, I'll take a ham and cheese sandwich, please.
老板，我要一个 cheese 火腿三明治。好 ，ham。Ham 就是火腿，它是当名词来用。例如 ，He put a slice of ham on his bread. He put a slice of ham on his bread. 他在面包上面放了一片火腿。再看个例句 ，This type of ham is known for its smoky flavor. This type of ham is known for its smoky flavor. 这种火腿是以它的烟熏风味而闻名的。好，回到课文里面，当番茄大战要来临的时候，你会看到村子里面广场挤满了20000个人，然后广场的正中央有竖立一根很高的柱子，上面涂满了油。好，那这个柱子的顶端还有放火腿，一旦有人能够成功爬上去拿到那块火腿，食物大战就要开打了。文中有两个补充单字。Greasy 是形容油腻的，还沾有油脂的。那么 pole 则是指杆子或者是柱子。Okay, everyone, we are almost through. The final paragraph of today's lesson tells us more about how the La Tomatina food fight works. Everyone starts fighting when someone gets the ham. Then, when the clock strikes 12, people stop throwing tomatoes.
Oh, and here we have the final vocabulary word of the day, strike. 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 It's a verb. In most cases, when we strike something, we hit that thing. That's not the case here. When a clock strikes a certain time, it reaches that time. And in some situations,It makes a sound, dong, dong, or something like that, indicating or telling you that that time has been reached. Now, people know when to stop throwing tomatoes and buñol during the La Tomatina festival because they hear this clock strike noon. For example, when the clock struck midnight, Cinderella's fantasy world was no more.
当午夜12点的钟声响起，魔法就失效了，仙杜瑞拉就被打回现实了。好 ，strike， strike 这个单字当动词，它有很多意思，像是击呀、打、攻击或是侵袭等等。不过它在课文里面是指时钟敲响、鸣起的动作。那么 strike 的动词三态是 strike、struck、struck。例如 ，The clock strikes every hour on the hour。The clock strikes every hour on the hour. 那个时钟每到整点的时候都会敲响。再看个例句。The clock struck 9 as he stepped into the office. The clock struck 9 as he stepped into the office. 当他踏进办公室的时候，这个9点的钟声就刚好响起了。好，番茄大战要打到什么时候才停下来呢？课文提到，当中午12点的钟声响起，人们就会停止丢番茄了。Okay, everyone, let's wrap things up. When the clock strikes 12, there in Bunyor during the La Tomatina festival, people stop throwing tomatoes.
Correct. And by that time, the square is covered in tomato sauce. So are all of the happy people there. They're also covered in tomato sauce. Anyways, apparently this mess... is a good mess. Okay, it makes people happy. There you have it. Anyway, with that, we are now done with this month's article. But as always, we sure hope you enjoyed reading this month's A Window on the World with us. For now, though, it's time for a break.
That's true, but you guys better not go anywhere. You see, this month's A Window on the World isn't over yet. We'll be back with a dialogue for you guys in no time.
La Tomatina, the world's biggest food fight.
Now, people throw the tomatoes for fun. It's a big event. Buñol buys over 100,000 kilograms of tomatoes. Store owners cover their windows with plastic sheets to protect them. When it's time, 20,000 people go into the village square. In the middle of the square, a ham sits on a tall, greasy pole. Once someone gets the ham, the food fight begins. When the clock strikes 12, people stop throwing tomatoes. By that time, the square is covered in tomato sauce. So are all of the happy people there.
Daphne. 今天我们总共要介绍三则文法。第一则是为了好玩的副词片语 for fun。第二则是以 B 覆盖 A 的动词片语 cover A with B。第三则是时间到了的副词子句 when it's time。让我们从为了好玩的副词片语开始吧。For fun 意思是为了好玩，接续词 for 意思是为了。名词 fun 是乐趣，合在一起 for fun 就是副词片语为了好玩，使用时置于动词及其受词后方。例如 ，Larry plays the piano just for fun。赖瑞弹钢琴只是弹好玩的。接着来看下一则文法 ，cover A with B 意思是以 B 覆盖 A。cover 是及物动词覆盖的意思。With 是介系词以用的意思，合在一起 cover A with B 就是以 B 覆盖 A。例如 ，Chester covered his belly with a blanket。切斯特用毯子盖住肚子。接着来看下一则文法。When it's time 意思是时间到了。When 是连接词当的意思，用来连接两个完整的子句，主词加动词。It's time 表示时间到了，后方可接不定词 to be 表示做点点点的时间到了。例如 ，Wave your hand when it's time to say goodbye， 到了告别时就挥一挥手。以上就是今天的三则文法，全民说英语，我们下次见喽。
A sentence a day。
Hi everyone, welcome to A Sentence A Day with me, Karen. 这个礼拜呢，要跟大家介绍的就是在借东西给别人的时候，我们会使用到的英文。今天呢，要讲的就是，也许你家里面已经有好几样，或者是一些不需要用的东西，你想要借给朋友，那你想说，没关系，你要用多久就用多久。这句英文可以怎么说呢？你可以说 ，Take this for as long as you need. Take this.For as long as you need. 你要用多久就用多久。For example, if I have two hair dryers at home and one of my friends does not have a hair dryer and I don't really need this one back right away, then I can tell my friend, it's okay, don't worry about it. Take this for as long as you need. Just give it back to me whenever you're done. Okay? And they will...feel really happy. They will really appreciate it. Okay? And that's the sentence for today. Take this for as long as you need. Very good. And then we'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Hello, 大家好，我是 Hanny， 又到我们一分钟的单元咯。那我们今天同样是用一分钟的时间帮大家复习在 A Window on the World 学到的四个单字。同学们，您都准备好没？一分钟计时开始。好，第一个单字是公斤，我们算数学常常写 kg 嘛，那 kg 是来自哪个字呢？就是 kilogram， kilogram。The elephant weighs more than 4,000 kilograms. 那一头大象体重超过4000公斤哦。好，再看第二单字，它可以指床单，或者是薄薄的布料，或者是一张纸啊，一片东西。这字叫做 sheet, sheet.
The artist hung a sheet to separate his studio from his sleeping area. 那位艺术家他挂了一块薄布料，把他的工作室跟睡觉的地方隔开来。再看第三个单词叫火腿，火腿好简单，叫做 ham。Ham. He had a ham sandwich and milk tea for breakfast. 他早餐吃火腿三明治配奶茶。好，再看第四个单字，它可以指打击啊，或者是袭击。在课文里面呢，它是指时钟敲响的意思。这个字叫 strike。Strike. 它动词三态是 strike, struck, struck. When the clock struck 12, she heard a knock on the door. 当十二点钟声响起，她听到敲门声。好，不管怎么样，我们在一分钟之内顺利复习完四个单字了，同学们表现很棒哦。那今天的 ABC Interactive English 到此为止，下次见咯，拜拜。